Good morning to all. My name is Roshni Rabi, nursing tutor of Indec Nursing College. Today my topic is pen. Introduction. Pain assessment is crucial if pain management is to be affecting. Nurses is in a unique position to assess pain as they have the most contact with the child and their family in hospital. Pain is the most common symptoms children experience in hospital. Acute pain is associated with tissue damage and an inflammatory response. It is self-limiting of short duration and does not involve neural tissue. Next, definition. Pain is an unpleasant sensory and emotional experience associated with or expressed in terms of actual or potential tissue damage. Or pain is whatever the experiencing person says it is existing whenever the experiencing person says it does. Aims. The guideline specifically seek to provide nurses with information regarding indications of pain assessment, types of tools used for pain assessment, documentation of pain assessment. So, assessment. Pain assessment is a broad concept involving clinical judgment based on observation of the type, significance, and context of the individual's pain experience. There are challenges in assessing pediatric pain known more so than in the pre-verbal and developmentally disabled child. Therefore, physiological and behavioral tools are used in place of the self-report of pain. However, in children with developmental disabilities, there can be incorrect assumptions and there is a risk of under-treating pain. It is important to take behavioral cues identifying by parents and caregivers to improve pain assessment in these children. Pain assessment in infants and children is also challenging due to the subjectivity and multidimensional nature of pain. The dependence on others to assess pain, limited language comprehension, and perception of pain expressed contextually in some children, it can be difficult to distinguish between pain, anxiety, and distress. Assessment and documenting pain is needed in order to improve management of pain. When assessing a child's level of pain, careful consideration needs to be given to their cognitive ability, environment, anxiety, and cause of pain. Example, post-operative. Measurement. Pain measurement quantifies pain intensity and enables the nurse to determine the efficacy of interventions aimed at reducing pain. A pain assessment should be conducted during a patient's admission. Link to nursing assessment, nursing clinical guideline. Points to consider. Pain history, location of pain, intensity of pain, cognitive development and understanding of pain. Types of pain: acute pain, chronic pain, neuropathic pain, nociceptive pain and radicular pain. First, acute pain. Acute pain begins suddenly and is usually sharp in quality. It serves as a warning of disease or a threat to the body. Acute pain might be caused by many events or circumstances, including surgical pain, traumatic pain, example, broken bone, cut or burn. Next, chronic pain. Chronic pain is pain that lasts for over 3 months. The pain can be there all the time or it may come and go. It can happen anywhere in your body. Chronic pain can interfere with your daily activities such as working, having a social life and taking care of yourself or others. Next, neuropathic pain. Neuropathic pain can happen if your nervous system is damaged or not working correctly. You can feel pain from any of the various levels of the nervous system, the peripheral nerves, the spinal cord, and the brain. Together, the spinal cord and the brain are known as the central nervous system. Next, nociceptive pain. Nociceptive pain is a type of pain caused by damage to body tissue. Nociceptive pain feels sharp, itching and or throbbing. It's often caused by an external injury like stubbing your toe, having a sports injury or a dental procedure. So next, radicular pain. Radicular pain is a type of pain that radiates from your back and hip into your legs through the spine. The pain travels along the spinal nerve's root. The leg pain can be accompanied by numbness, tingling, and muscle weakness. Radicular pain occurs when the spinal nerves get compressed or inflamed. The meaning of compressed is pinched. When to assess pain? Pain scores should be documented for all children at least once per shift in flow sheet. Children with pain should have pain scores documented more frequently. Children who are receiving oral analgesia should have pain scores documented at least 4 hourly during working hours. Children on complex analgesia such as intravenous opioid and or ketamine, epidural or regional analgesia should have hourly pain and sedation score documentation. assess and document pain before and after analgesia and document effects. Assess and document pain on activities such as physiotherapy. Pain assessment tools. Tools used for pain assessment at RCH have been selected on their validity, reliability, and usability, and are recognized by pain specialists to be clinically effective in assessing acute pain. All share a common numeric and recorded as value 0 to 10 and documented on the clinical observation charts as the 5th vital sign. The importance of using the same numeric value 0 to 10 is that the number relates to the same pain intensity in each tool. Three ways of measuring pain. Self-report, what the child says. The gold standard. Next is behavioral, how the child behaves. Next, physiological clinical observation. FLACC. FLACC, the acronym FLACC standard for face, legs, activity, cry, and consolability. Behavioral, 2 months at years and also used up to 18 years for children with cognitive impairment and or developmental disabilities. Okay, always elicit support from parents or carers to help with pain assessment. It may be difficult to assess children with cognitive impairment and or are non-verbal. Ask the parents or carer to help you explain their child's pain behavior. How to use FLACC. FLACC, the acronym FLACC stand for leg, activity, cry, and consolability. Face, legs, activities, cry, and consolability. ठीक है? Zero means face में zero means no particular expression or smile. One is occasional grimace or frown, withdrawn, disinterested. Two is frequent, two constant, frown, clenched jaw, and curving chin. Legs is zero, normal position or relaxed. One is uneasy, restless, tense. Two is kicking or leg drawn up. Activity means zero is lying quickly, normal position, moves easily. One is squirming, shifting back and forth, tense. Two is arched, rigid and jerking. ठीक है? Cry, zero is no cry, awake or asleep. One is moans or whimpers, occasional complaints. Two is crying steadily, screams or sobs, frequent complaints. Constability, zero is content, relaxed. One is reassured by occasional touching, hugging or talking to distractible. Two is difficult to console or comfort. Wong Baker faces pain scale. The measurement is in the children's 3 to 18 years of age. How to use? Explain to the person that each phase is for a person who feels happy because he has no pain, or sad because he has some or a lot of pain. Phase 0 is very happy because he does not hurt at all. Phase 2 hurt just a little bit. Phase 4 hurts a little more. Phase 6 hurt even more. Phase 8 hurt a whole lot. Phase 10 hurt as much as you can imagine. Although you don't have to be crying to feel this bad. Ask the person to choose the phase that best describes how he is feeling. Wong-Baker faces pain rating scale. Zero is very happy because he does not hurt at all. Okay? Then phase 2 is hurt just a little bit. Okay? Then phase 4 hurt a little more. Then phase 6 hurt a little much more. Okay? Hurt even much more. Then phase 8 hurt a whole lot. Then phase 10 hurt as much you can imagine. ठीक है, जितना आप इमेजिन कर सकते हो. देन विजुअल एनालॉग स्केल 8 years एंड ओल्डर. ठीक है, हाउ टू यूज. आस्क द चाइल्ड यूजिंग नंबर्स फ्रॉम 0 इज इक्वल टू नो पेन थ्रू टू 10 बींग द वर्स्ट पेन. ठीक है, न्यूमेरिक रेटिंग स्केल इट मीन्स 0 इज नो पेन एंड 1 to 10 इज डिटरमाइन द पेन. Pain assessment 1 is normal, 2 is little bit more, ठीक है, and 10 is worse pain. Next one is pain management. So first is NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, ठीक है, provide mild to moderate pain relief and also reduce fever and inflammation by inhibiting the production of prostaglandins. Next one is ibuprofen. Motrin is safe for infants 6 months or older. It is typically prescribed every 6 to 8 hours. Naproxen is longer acting than ibuprofen and is typically prescribed 2 to 3 times a day with a full glass of water. Ketorolac toradol is commonly used to treat breakthrough pain that occurs during the treatment of severe acute pain already being treated with opioids. Opioid analgesic. Opioids are used to treat moderate to severe pain and work by blocking the release of neurotransmitters involved in the processing of pain. Different opioids have different amount of analgesia, ranging from codeine used to treat mild to moderate pain up to morphine used to treat severe pain and considered to be at the top of the WHO ladder. And next is fentanyl. And then thank you.